Today is all about microscopes. We're going to discuss whether or not you need a microscope for your science units, how to choose one, how to understand the different parts of the microscope, how to set it up and use it, and then we're going to troubleshoot. I'm Amy, and I work with the curriculum development team for The Good and the Beautiful. Now, if you're like most people, you probably haven't used a microscope since you were in school yourself. Microscopes can be a little intimidating to use, but once you understand the basics, they are a wonderful tool to utilize in your homeschool. Several of the Good and Beautiful science units include microscope activities, but it's important to note that these activities are always optional. You can absolutely complete the science units even if you do not own a microscope. However, including a microscope in your unit can really bring science to life for your children and enhance their science experience. The text for this video can be found on our website, goodandbeautiful.com/blog, if you want to reference any of the information. All right, the first step is choosing and purchasing your microscope. There are actually two basic types of microscopes, stereo and compound. Stereo microscopes are typically low-power microscopes designed for observing whole objects like flower pollen, and they actually reflect the light off the surface of the object. A compound microscope is used to magnify the tiny details and structures of cells and other objects by shining light through them. All of the microscope activities in the Good and Beautiful curriculum call for a compound microscope, so that's what you'll want to purchase. The next thing you want to look for when you buy your microscope is the magnification. Your microscope needs at least a 40x through 400x range. And if you're looking to invest in a microscope that will last the life of your homeschool and can be used for any possible science experiments up through high school courses, you may want to consider one that has a range up to 1000x. But a microscope with 400x magnification is sufficient for most activities. A couple other things to look for are optical glass lenses and wide-field eyepieces. With a wide-field eyepiece, the lens opening is significantly larger, and this makes it much easier for children to look through the eyepiece. You're going to find the link for our recommended microscope in the comments below. It's a great mid-range microscope that has all of these features, but any similar microscope will work. I have our recommended microscope here. If you don't have this particular microscope, don't worry. The basic parts of each compound microscope will be the same. Okay, let's start at the top of our microscope and work our way down. At the top, we have our eyepiece or our ocular lens. This is what you look through at the top of the microscope. Standard eyepieces have a magnifying power of 10x, which is what this one has. The eyepiece tube holds the lens in place above the objective lens. The objective lenses, these are the primary lenses on a microscope. They range from 4x through 100x and typically include 3, 4, or 5 lenses on most microscopes. As you can see, this microscope has 3 objective lenses, but if yours has 4 or 5, that's just fine. The nose piece here holds our objective lenses and it can rotate so that you can conveniently select which objective lens you need. The focus knobs are used to focus the microscope once you're looking at your specimen. These may be separate on your microscope, one big and one small, or they may be together with the coarse knob on the outside and the fine knob on the inside, like this one. The stage here is where the specimen is placed to be viewed. The stage clips hold the slide in place. Here in the middle, you'll see the hole, that's the aperture. It allows light to reach your specimen. And down below, the illuminator is the light source for the microscope. The iris diaphragm here on the side of the stage allows you to adjust how much light is going through your aperture. On the back, you'll find the light switch. And on the side here is the light adjustment. You can turn the light source on and off and adjust the amount of light coming through the illuminator. Okay, we're ready to start using our microscope. First, we'll need a slide. I have prepared a dry mount slide here. Dry mount just means that you put your specimen directly on the slide and cover it with a slip cover. In some experiments, you will actually use a wet mount slide instead, which is when you add a drop of liquid to your slide before putting the slip cover on. The science unit will let you know how to prepare your slides. I'm going to go ahead and put the slide onto the stage here and secure it with the stage clips. Then you'll want to center the specimen over the aperture and turn the light on. Now turn your nose piece so the lowest objective is centered over your slide. In my case, that's the 4x objective lens. Remember, the eyepiece has a magnification of 10x, so when I use the 4x objective lens, I'm actually getting a total magnification of 40x, or 10 times 4. You always, always want to start with the lowest objective. Now go ahead and look through the eyepiece and use the coarse knob to bring the specimen into focus. Once you can see it clearly, go ahead and rotate the nose piece so that you are using the next objective lens. For me, that's the 10x lens. I now have a magnification of 100x, or 10 times 10. All right, look through the eyepiece again and use the coarse knob to bring your specimen into focus. You'll continue using this process, working up through the different lenses to increase the magnification each time. Once you get to the 40x lens, or 400 magnification, you need to switch to the fine knob for focusing instead of the coarse knob to get a crystal clear image. You will not need to go higher than 400x for most activities, although it may be exciting to explore each specimen under higher magnification. Now, just a couple tips for using your microscope. If you need to move your slide while viewing, remember that when you view a specimen through a microscope, you are actually viewing an image through multiple lenses. As a result, the image is upside down and back to front. So when you move the slide to the right, the image moves to the left, and vice versa. This can be a little tricky for kids when they are first starting out. If you move the slide too much, you may lose the specimen in your viewing field completely, especially at higher magnification. In this case, go ahead and start over at the lowest magnification, find your specimen, and work your way up again, focusing as you go. When using a microscope with a single eyepiece like this one, the correct technique is to look through the eyepiece with one eye and keep the other eye open. Most new users tend to close one eye, but that can cause eye strain and headaches. So try to remember to keep both eyes open and encourage your children to do the same. If you're not getting a clear image using the focus knobs, there are a couple things you can try. First, go back to the lowest objective and try refocusing again. If that doesn't work, try to adjust your light source, if it is adjustable on your microscope. Brighter is not always better. Play with the amount of light while viewing your specimen to see if more or less light improves the clarity. Next, you can try cleaning your lens by moistening the end of a Q-tip with the lens cleaner or window cleaner mixed with vinegar and rub the lens in a circular motion. Then use the dry end of the Q-tip to gently dry the lens. When carrying your microscope, put one hand under the base and one hand around the neck. Always supervise children when they are carrying the microscope. They are generally a little heavy and may easily break if dropped. If you have one, store your microscope under a dust cover to prevent the lenses from getting dirty between uses. Finally, if your children love the microscope and want to do more with it, you can buy sets of pre-prepared slides with all kinds of different specimens to observe. These can be found on Amazon or other educational and science websites. This can be a great way to explore more of the world with your children. I hope you feel ready and excited to jump into the world of microscopes. Don't forget to subscribe for more tips, tricks, and inspiration for teaching science. Comment below and let us know your favorite thing to use a microscope for, or how you want to use a microscope in your homeschool.